This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, oh my gosh, I am so wonderfully overwhelmed. Chef Charles is here from Winging It, and he's brought wings, he's brought desserts, he's brought bacon-wrapped meatloaf. That's what we're making today in the kitchen, right?
It is correct.
All right, take us through the ingredients, first and foremost.
We have some bell peppers, onions, salt, pepper, a little bit of brown sugar, ketchup, eggs, some breadcrumbs that, again, we make in-house, milk, chopped onions, shredded cheddar cheese, and some of our house-made barbecue sauce.
All right, and the meat, too.
The meat is bacon. Some pork. Ground hamburger that we grind on site, our smoked in-house bacon.
You keep saying we do that on site. We do that on site. You pretty much do everything right
there. We do. We have a whole bakery, all our fresh breads, pastries, everything is made in-house.
Our counter is covered, and even the wings. My gosh, I have a menu here because you have 80 sauces
80
for
different
your wing.
Sauces
you're called Winging
growing.
It, so
yes.
Of course you got to try the wings while you're there. Check this out. They even have fluffernutter sauce, pineapple habanero, spicy Italian, white barbecue, teriyaki, sesame soy ginger, general tows, duck, strawberry glaze, almond joy. I could be here for 5 minutes just reading all of these sauces, but they sound awesome.
Yes, we take a lot of pride in what we do. Everything is made from scratch. Nothing's out of a bottle.
Does that go for the pastries, too?
Everything. It all started out with flour, eggs, water, and a little yeast.
Oh, man. You throw a little love in there, too,
yes,
right?
Yes.
I am so excited for this recipe and to talk more about all the treats and your place, of course, but we're going to have to wait on that.
All right, we shall wait.
Stick around. We have plenty more coming up.
Are winging it back over to the kitchen here. You may have puppies. I've got bacon here in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Chef Charles is here. Winging it's on the menu. We got bacon wrapped meatloaf.
Yes, that is correct.
Just the sound of that is making me like dizzy.
And it's a blanket of bacon wrapped meatloaf.
Nice and warm and toasty with that blanket of bacon. All right,
yes,
what do we need to do? Because you got a lot of stuff.
All right, what I like to do is start off with all my wet ingredients. So
okay.
We'll just dump some of the eggs in.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll take the milk.
Now, is that just the yolk, or did you...
Nope, that's just like a scrambled egg. That's
okay.
All that is.
Right.
If you want to grab some ingredients,
sure.
You're just dumping them in.
We'll chalk through this so everybody knows. We've got some onion here, too, right?
Some ketchup.
Some onion.
Ketchup.
What kind of cheese we got?
The cheese is going to hold off for a moment. That's what we're going
to
actually stuff the meatloaf with.
Yes,
some salt.
What about this?
That is breadcrumbs.
All
yes,
right.
We can dump that right in.
All right, I'm going to put this in.
Some brown sugars right here.
Okay. Put that in.
We got some peppers right there, black pepper.
The whole thing or just
the whole
dump
thing.
It in. This is an easy recipe.
Yeah, that's some garlic.
Okay, dump that in.
And then Worcestershire.
Mm-hmm.
Just a little bit of Worcestershire.
Just
and then my favorite ingredient, which would be the bell pepper.
Really? Nice. So all this is in here, okay?
Yeah. Now we're gonna just take this is our fresh ground pork. And we're gonna take the ground hamburger.
When I go to the market and I'm looking, do we need like 80%, you know, as far as fat content?
I prefer a little bit fatter content because it's going to mostly cook off.
And I guess if you're wrapping it in bacon, it really,
it doesn't matter when it comes to that content of it.
And, I probably shouldn't have been asked that question.
Yeah. And we go with the old style, just mixing it with your hands, just making sure it's all...
Really getting in there with
exactly,
it.
Exactly.
All right, so you're mixing this away. We're going to get putting the rest of this stuff together. And he didn't just bring this. There's a whole side over here to the left where there is just a ton of food, and we're going to check that out in just a little bit. Back to you. If you are hungry, you have come to the right place this morning. Chef Charles is here from Winging It. Bacon wrapped meatloaf along with just about 50 other things are on the menu today.
So full.
Wow.
I am just so excited.
We don't know what to say. There's so much stuff.
Speechless is a good thing.
Yeah,
though.
It is. It really
especially
is.
Especially in the kitchen.
So what we're going to do here is we're going to take the residual meat from that we had.
Right. Because you already blended this.
Yep.
We already blended this together. You mixed it together.
Yep.
Put everything together.
And just layer it in like a loaf.
Okay.
And you're pieing that into bacon that you've already cooked for a little bit, right?
Yes. For about 20 minutes, you want to pre-cook the blanket of bacon.
Mm-hmm. And what kind of bacon is this? Because it's not very thin cut. It's
nope. We actually buy our pork belly. Fresh, we cure it, and then smoke it in our own smoker.
This is Winging It
bacon. That is the real deal.
I have to say, this is a blanket that I want to curl
wow,
up in right
wee.
Now.
So what we're going to do here, this is why I said to save the cheese, because this is where we make the little pocket of...
Look, if you didn't think it could get any better because it had bacon, now he's jamming cheese into this.
And this is great game day food.
That's it.
I mean, who doesn't love anything wrapped in bacon? Yes. If you can wrap meat in bacon. Here.
This is where the true test comes
How
in.
How does this?
Oh.
Wow.
And
impressive.
That is.
Look, I know you can see this on TV, but you have no idea what this really looks like.
Wow.
This is
and the
out
smell
of control.
In here, too, with all the different sauces and the bacon. And
now
wow.
we just mop it. Mop it
up.
What type of sauce are you using here? You mentioned before you have 80 sauces at Wingin' It.
Yes, this is our house-made Jesse James bourbon barbecue.
Okay, wow. I like that.
So we take Jesse James bourbon.
Yes.
Take the Jesse James bourbon, reduce it down, and you just want to make sure everything is covered with it, so that way when it bakes.
Can you smell
it?
The smell is fantastic.
Oh,
yes.
Between that and everything else that's going on this counter, my goodness. All right, so when we bake that, Chef, time and temp.
Yes, we want to cook it because it does have pork in it, so we want to bring it up to 170 degrees.
Okay.
For 350 degrees for approximately an hour and 10 minutes.
Okay. Right?
So depending on each ovens are different.
All right. Okay. So you can pop that in there. As you keep going with that sauce there.
Yes, mop it, mop it.
Can you mention some of the other meat items that you have in front? Obviously the wings. We have to focus on the wings because your place is called Wingin' It.
Yes, these are our smoked wings. That's why we use a full wing for a smoke because it holds in smoke flavor a little bit more. That is our Louisville style ribs.
Yum.
Over here we have a full chicken which I caught cut in half so that way
Fantastic.
It was viewable.
Love that.
These are our charbroiled wings, all our fresh Kimmelwick buns, our sourdough buns.
Yum. All right, up here.
This is the famous tomahawk steak.
Oh. That is a
32 ounces of just pure love right there.
Wow,
that
wait.
Looks delicious. Just some of the 80 sauces you brought along too, right?
As well as the brownie cookies, which is the non-traditional. Are,
a brownie cookie?
Yes.
I mean, come on.
Dude, I think I may be in love.
Look what he's even done to the cupcakes. Taken off the top, stuffed them up, and maybe the largest toasted coconut
massive.
Cake you have ever seen. It is the size of my head. Can you see this right now? It is very impressive.
Five layers.
Wow. Five layers? Oh,
okay, let's give everybody out there a breath. Let's soak it all in. Soak it all in. Now give the address out there of where you're located.
We are at 549 Medicom Ave in Bristol, Rhode Island, right next to Arnold Lumber.
Okay.
Nice. All right, so we're going to have to check that out. Just try one of everything.
Yes.
Try all the sauces. Try one of everything. Whew. You also said really quick, too, you can split the orders of the sauce, right?
That is correct.
You can try a couple all in one order of chicken wings.
Man,
all right.
Man.
If you want this recipe and, gosh, the address where you can get all of these great items, head on over to our website. It's the Roadshow page at WPRI.com.